Hey, please join me as I upgrade my application from Expo SDK 53 to Expo SDK 54 beta in real time. And don't worry, these steps will work as well with the stable release once it's out, which should be in about 2 weeks. All right, let's dive in. Here I have an application that I've been working on and it uses SDK 53. Let me show you. Here it is, 53. Okay, so let's quit this. And the first thing that I want to do is actually run this command. npx expo install expo at next with the fix flag. And even if you want, before you do that, just go through the change log that we published a couple days ago. And we actually have a section about upgrading at the very end that you can refer to as well. And here's the command that I'm actually running. So let's just press enter. And the command is done. As you can see, it installed a bunch of dependencies and then fixed the versions of my project. Now, if we check out the package JSON, you'll notice that my expo version is now 54 preview and it installed all the things that we needed, okay? Now, let's go back and I'm going to run expo doctor. So in case you didn't know, expo comes with something called expo doctor and you can just run npx expo doctor in your project and this will analyze your project and let you know if something is wrong about it. So right now we have three checks that are not passing are giving us a warning. First of all, we recently added a check for per dependencies that need to be installed with the packages that you are using. So what I have to do here is install these dependencies so that this warning is gone and my project will work correctly. And then with Reanimated version 4, they introduce a new pair dependency, which is React Native Worklets. When I say npx expo install expo session and React Native Worklets. Okay, hit enter and that's done. Okay, now let's run doctor again. And now we only have two checks that are not passing. By the way, React Native Worklets has a plugin. So we're actually handling that for you. You don't need to do anything else. Just install React Native Worklets and it should work. I have this warning that is telling me that I have a bunch of duplicate dependencies. And this is because I already had node modules installed, right, in my project and it was using Expo 53. And when I upgraded, since I'm using Bun, I think there's actually an issue and Bun is not detecting duplicates. So in this case, the fix for that is just actually removing the node modules and installing again dependencies. And I'm going to remove node modules and as well my bun log file and then run bun install. Let's see if that fixes the issue. Okay, it's done. Let's run doctor again and the issue is fixed. So you might see this warning, especially if you're using bun like me, but once you remove the log file and node modules and then install everything in a clean state, it should get rid of that issue and you shouldn't have any duplicates. Now the last warning is actually telling me that some of these dependencies that I'm using in my project are not included in the React Native directory. Now, that doesn't really mean that they are not going to work. It's just that it's a warning telling us that no one has tested this in the new architecture and might not work. But actually, I know that it works. And I actually know that some of these dependencies are being added to the React Native directory. So you shouldn't see them if you are using them. But anyways, after that, I'm going to create a new build. So when I say npx expo rebuild platform iOS with the clean flag, let's do that. Okay, now let's build my application on my iOS simulator by saying npx expo run iOS. And just like that, hit enter. And the build is in progress. And a cool thing about SDK 54 is that React Native is precompiled, which means the build should be fairly fast. All right, that was fairly quick. And my build is being installed. My app, it's working just fine. And now I can enjoy of Expo SDK 54 and all the new features. Now let's test this on Android. I'm going to pre-build for Android with the clean flag. And finally, let's run it on Android. Let's wait a moment. All right, and the build was successful. It's installing it and opening it. Boom, how cool is that? Awesome, and my app is working just fine on Android as well. So I'm super excited for this. We've been working on making the upgrade smooth for you guys. And if you encounter any issues, please reach out and we'll get that fixed for you as soon as possible. Thanks for watching and I'll see you.